one of those hypnotic shows where they encourage you to believe you can score goals like a Brazilian.
Ian Payne and Sue Thirl with those games. Incidentally, the draw for the third round is live on BBC Radio 5 tomorrow night at 6:20. Now, if you're not entirely overwhelmed by all that, some more goals coming your way now, 10 in fact to see, and an invitation to enter our Goal of the Month competition. As ever, you have to pick the top three in the right order to agree with our panellists here.
Beattie meets the cross. Here's Letizia up against Southgate. And he's shaking him off. And he's found the net! It's Matt Letizia with a typical goal for Southampton. Another Southampton attack breaking down, and it was Gareth Barry that brought the ball out, and he's found Collymore. An early ball into Merson. Oh, what a good finish. Paul Merson for Villa. And this is Froggatt for Coventry now, with a lot of space in front of him. Everton backpedalling. Oh, what a good effort, and what a fine goal by Stephen Froggatt. Well, even in the wake of Dion Dublin's departure, Coventry are moving the ball about well. This is Froggatt. Oh, that's a great ball. It's Huckabee. Oh, and fine goal by Coventry.
Half a clearance, here's Lennon, and now Guffey, who's curled it, and a score!
Again, a few options. Oh, but he doesn't need them! Charlton back in the game with 25 minutes left. With the free kick, two men in the box. This is Kewell. Step over by Smith. Hasselbank back to Smith, and he scores. Two goals in two games for the young man.
Oakley to Oystenster. That's Ripley. Carlton Palmer now back in the action. Oh, it's a good back heel by Carlton Palmer. Good chance here for Southampton. The first of the game. Matthew Oakley puts Southampton in the lead. Kitson does well. Sinclair with a chance. Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Plenty of players back. Liverpool going across the field at the moment. Staunton. And now Fowler, good touch. Here's Ince. Oh, it's in! Paul Ince! What a goal!
So pick your top three in the right order. The phone number you can see, a VIP day out for two at a match of your choice, is the prize. Finally, match of the day is man of the day, where we like to encourage new managers. Now, some teams can win nothing with kids, but Blackburn Rovers have won a match at last with Kidd, Brian Kidd. From us, good night.
Alan Davis and Anthony Hopkins are Clive Anderson's guests next tonight on BBC One. Then it's Top of the Pops with Steps, All Saints and Madonna at 25 to 1. Jimmy Floyd Hasselbank, his name, his game and life at Leeds in the January issue of BBC Match of the Day magazine.
Liverpool, June 1998. A gang of boys live 3 weeks of feverish fantasy. Their dreams are not that their parents will win the lottery. They dream that Owen will score a goal and England will win the World Cup.
They're not going to lose because they're not going to win, you know.
Come on, England. Tuesday at 9:30 on BBC Two.
Broken bones. Broken hearts.
I can't do this anymore.
And broken homes.
I wish you had smell-o-vision because you could smell your stinks.
For the peaced population of Val d'Isère, the hangover continues.
Just want to go home.
War and Peace, Wednesday 10:15 on BBC One.
Now on BBC One, more Yakety Yak with Clive.
Thank you. Welcome to Clive Anderson All Talk. Now, two or three years ago, the best-known magician's assistant in the country was the lovely Debbie McGee. That's all changed since my first guest tonight was lured from a conventional career in stand-up comedy into the crazy world of BBC Saturday evening drama. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome TV's Jonathan Creek and stand-up's Alan Davies. Alan Davies!
To you.
How are you?
I'm very well.
Good. Good.
You have your very own special walk when you're on stage.
Do I have a walk?
I can't do it. You sort of, it's not a slouch, it's not a sort of, it's like an animal, a caged animal, a bit.
We had to do this thing when I was a student. I did theatre.
Yes.
Which is a bit dull.
3 years of drama.
Four years of it. Oh, God. Can you just please stop telling me about it? Yeah. And we did this thing one day, and we did about one term of acting classes, which was no help whatsoever to anyone. Yeah. And they said, can you... Now, we want you to try and find some sort of neutral persona from which you can build into a part, right?
Right.
So we were like, yeah, whatever. Big coats of smoking or whatever. I think he's an idiot, you know. And then you start walking around the room, and they make you exaggerate the way you walk. They say... Everyone has to pick on you, you know. They have to say, oh, you're leaning forward slightly and you're swinging your left arm a bit and you sort of tip your head to the side. And I ended up walking around the room, I was sort of walking like this. And they said to me, that's basically you. Now you have to work back.
Yeah.
Yeah.